Hey, how's it going, fight fans? Welcome to mindforcombat. If you're new to the channel, my name is Rohan. This is my platform where I do fight sports related content. If you're new here, why don't you help me grow my platform? All you have to do is subscribe to the channel, like the video if you like it, and maybe hit that bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a video. With that said, in this video, I'll be breaking down the upcoming co-main event between Jack Hermansson and Kelvin Gastelum in a card that was meant to be being headlined by Joseph Benavidez and Davison Figueiredo, their second fight. Unfortunately, that fight looks like it's about to fall through with Davison testing positive for COVID-19. So, you know, obviously, I wish him a fast recovery. Hope he's feeling better. And in this video for this week, I'll be covering the co-main event instead, as we see what happens with the main event working out. Obviously, last week with the fallout of Gilbert Burns, I wasn't able to cover the Jorge Masvidal and Kamaru Usman fight. I wasn't able to give a breakdown for that. But you know what, it is the way it is. I was still happy to be able to get some content out there. Obviously, I work a full-time job whilst doing this as a hobby, so I hope you guys can appreciate that. Sorry I wasn't able to cover that. But anyways, guys, I'm going to try and keep the content coming out for you. I always do. I always got something coming out for you guys, no matter how busy I get, because this is what I love doing. So I would really appreciate if you guys could subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. Anyways, with that said, this is a very interesting fight. So both of these guys are coming off losses. Well, in Kelvin Gastelum's case, he's coming off two losses, but it's a bit different for these guys because they're both seen as top contenders, and a winner here would most certainly still be in line for maybe one or two fights away from a title shot if they can get that, you know, that string of victories coming together. So for Kelvin Gastelum, he of course had that fight of the year candidate with Israel Adesanya for the interim title. Now he didn't win that, he fell short of winning that, and then after that he followed that with really a lackluster performance in his loss against Darren Till. Darren Till was of course making his middleweight debut. And for Jack Hermansson, he's coming off a big loss to Jared Cannonier. And before that, he had a good bit of momentum going, you know, with some good wins as well. He was seen as a top contender in the division. So a win here is really pivotal for both men, particularly Kelvin Gastelum, because if he loses here, he's on a three-fight losing streak, and it's really tough to see where he goes from here. But a win here puts both of these guys right where they need to be in terms of being able to negotiate a big fight that could potentially get him a title shot with the fallout of the division and everything that's going on at 185 right now. So with that said, let's go through the tail of the tape and let's break this one down. So Jack Hermansson is 32 years old, which makes him 4 years older than Kelvin Gastelum. So both of these guys are in their physical primes. I see no issues there. Jack Hermansson has a professional record of 20 wins and 5 losses. Obviously, he's coming off a loss. He's been around in the UFC for a long time, but he's an experienced veteran. He's been there, seen it all. And I don't think he's going to be impacted by the main event spot. He's been in main events before, and he fights Kelvin Gastelum, who's got 15 wins and 5 losses with 1 no contest. Now, Kelvin Gastelum is a, you know, he's a really rugged veteran at this point. He's been around, he's main event in many cards in the UFC, and he's done really, really well in main event places. And he's come out there and he put on some really mind-boggling performances in you know, in huge cards, like when he was facing Tim Kennedy. He stepped in late notice and fought some really good guys. So Kelvin Gastelum, he's been around in the main events for a long while as well, so this isn't a guy who's going to be who's going to have any issues with dealing with the main event spotlight. So in terms of experience, I see no issues there either. So this is actually a really good matchup of two guys that are looking to rebound and guys that are relatively similar in age and have you know, comparable experience. It's a really, really good fight actually. I really, really like this one. Jack Hermansson stands at 6'1", and this is where the differences start to show between Kelvin Gastelum and the other middleweights, because Kelvin Gastelum stands at 5'9", which makes him 3-4 inches shorter than Jack Hermansson. Jack Hermansson is a much taller man, and he'll also enjoy a nice 6-inch reach advantage with a 77.5-inch reach, as opposed to Kelvin Gastelum's 71.5-inch reach. So really, he's going to be enjoying some nice size over Kelvin Gastelum. Kelvin Gastelum has really made his career based off his explosive, fast movements, fast hands, and he's going to need to rely on that in this fight, because Jack Hermansson is no doubt going to be trying to fight on the outside and try to utilize the range that he will enjoy, and I think he would enjoy a large bit of leg reach as well. So it's going to be interesting to see how Kelvin Gastelum deals with that distancing. To talk about this style as well, Jack Hermansson, he can do it all really. I feel like he's a very well-rounded fighter, as we've seen in his fights previously. He did get cold cocked by Jared Cannonier, and that kind of happens when you're fighting someone as dangerous as Jared Cannonier. But I think he's got good stand-up. I think he's got a good ground game. I don't think he excels particularly at either one of those things. I think he's a great conditioned athlete who's very strong, hits relatively hard, and he's pretty tough to put away, pretty durable. He's kind of good at everything. He's really well-rounded. I don't think he excels at anything. With Kelvin Gastelum, I think he's pretty well-rounded as well. Of course, he's a somewhat decorated wrestler. He's, of course, got really good boxing skills. I think he's got a cast iron chin, great conditioning when he's in good shape, and he's got lightning fast hands. I think where Kelvin Gastelum does excel, actually, is in his boxing. I think he's got really, really good boxing, and he's really creative with his hands, and he makes people struggle to figure out what he's doing with his hands. I actually really like Kelvin Gastelum in terms of his boxing skill set, so that's where he shines in this. Jack Hermansson's issue is definitely going to be, I think, when you're coming off a huge knockout loss the way he is, you've got to question his chin a little bit. I think that's going to be up for debate, and in there with a guy like Kelvin Gastelum, who hits hard and has fast hands, and you know he's a really good boxer, he's going to get cracked at some point in those three rounds. And I think Kelvin Gastelum will be able to find his chin, to be honest with you. So how is this chin going to hold up after getting cracked the way he did against Jared Cannonier back in September last year? So it's going to be interesting to see how he deals with that. And for Kelvin Gastelum, the biggest issue I see for him coming into this fight, and it's going to be every middleweight fight, is his size. If his opponents are able to leverage their size against Kelvin Gastelum accurately, they will have a good time keeping him away, because he's so small compared to these other guys. The X factor for Jack Hermansson is, of course, going to be, you know, on the offset of Kelvin Gastelum's biggest issue, is going to be Jack Hermansson's size. How he utilizes his size is going to be very interesting. And for Kelvin Gastelum, his biggest X factor is going to be his hand speed and his boxing in general. The way he puts his hands on Jack Hermansson is going to be really, really interesting. Let's get into the prediction. This is a fight that will be fought on the feet, in my opinion. I believe that Kelvin Gastelum has a superior wrestling. If he wants to take it down, he probably can. I don't think that he will want to. I think Kelvin Gastelum likes to box and likes to stay outside and lunge in with those explosive dynamic punches. And I think Jack Hermansson can't take down Kelvin Gastelum if he wants. With that said, even though I think Kelvin Gastelum enjoys a huge advantage over Jack Hermansson when it comes to boxing, this isn't a boxing match, and I think Jack Hermansson's probably got really good kicks that he can cause Kelvin Gastelum some trouble with, and even his size is going to make it really difficult for Kelvin Gastelum to be able to break that distance. Jack Hermansson's an experienced fighter and a talented striker, if not, you know, obviously not a K-1 class striker, but he's a talented striker, and he'll cause Kelvin Gastelum a lot of problems, in my opinion. What I think will happen is, as this fight plays out, Kelvin Gastelum will get more and more comfortable with his boxing. He will start getting into range, and he'll start landing shots that will really, really make a difference. As those shots land, I think Jack Hermansson is going to get worn out and slowed down. I think Jack Hermansson is going to get cracked. He's going to get cracked hard, and I don't think he's going to deal with it well. And at that point, Kelvin Gastelum's going to let hell loose on him, and I think Kelvin Gastelum's going to get a finish. So, fight fans, for my official prediction, I'm predicting that Kelvin Gastelum will probably be able to, you know, deal with some early troubles that he's going to have, you know, get used to the size of Jack Hermansson. And once he gets used to the size of Jack Hermansson, I believe he's going to beat Jack Hermansson up, and he's going to start to put those hands really on him, and he's going to start to really, you know, cause him trouble, crack him, and then he's going to get the finish probably towards the end of round three. So, fight fans, for my official prediction, I'm going with Kelvin Gastelum for a late finish in this fight, and I think it's a really, really good fight for Kelvin Gastelum. Good fight for Jack Hermansson as well. I'm not completely counting him out, but I think just based on what I see, the balance of probability, I have to lean with Kelvin Gastelum to get the win. So, fight fans, Kelvin Gastelum for the win. Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed the breakdown. If you're new to the channel, please do remember to subscribe, like, share, all that jazz. Comment below with your predictions and let me know what you thought about my breakdown. Thank you for watching, guys. I'm Rohan, and this is Mindful Combat.